But you say like, come commit it and we had the different people from different countries. So we but luckily we managed to communicate. You see, communication is illegal. And in like permanence in Africa camp, Gwen was there, then we were like four girls. We met like the girls who we came from Lusaka going to that same camp. So I learned about self-esteem, leadership, and how to prevent myself from entering like whoever memories of putting a punch. So I learned about a lot of things there and I really enjoyed. You see? So by time camp in Asira, us who are going to Lusaka and say it's not doing. So I'm going back home to the noisy and the stressing day. I mean, it's not the funny sound to go on to much. So anyway, I just had to accept because the camp has finished and everything has finished. So we went back to Lusaka. We reached in Lusaka. So at the time we reached in Lusaka, like Sadiq had invited us like, to be coming like on Saturdays and be learning more and learning more. So I got interested in this. So I used to make sure like when it's Saturday, I need to get ready, like do my chores, all of them in time and just go there and learn. So like as I was going at Mr. D's place and learning things, I got more interested. At the time he told me that we'll teach like because we had they gave us Raspberry Pis at that time. So they told us that this Raspberry Pi you should be going and teaching people. So when I got that Raspberry Pi with Gwen and the other girls, went at opposite the community center where I got the papers from. So when we went there, it wasn't easy for me like teaching people. So I thought of like starting with like just young kids, like young kids. So I started teaching young kids and Gwen was there helping me, so we were teaching, but it wasn't easy. But luckily we never give up. You see, like we were just busy helping the kids, teaching them. Then we just found out that some big people were also interested in what we were doing. So like when they find me at that library, they used to ask me, what's that weird thing you have in your hands? Because like a Raspberry Pi looks very small. So like people used to call me a girl with the little with the tiny computer. They used to call me that. So I found out like big people were really interested and all that. So I told Ren about it. Then Ren was saying, no, it's fine. We can teach these people. And I was nervous because okay, although the big people were teaching, they were women. But I never had that experience of standing in front of a big person and teaching them the knowledge that I have. Because like I have situation whereby someone tells me you can't do anything, telling me directly to my face that you can't do anything. You're like bad, like you're really bad. Like someone tells me that. So but So I didn't give up. So we started teaching those women, we taught them and they understand two or three things. I even taught my mom how to use a Raspberry Pi and yeah, she knows. So and Mr. D told me that we're going to be going like different places and teaching people, so I was really excited of that. So we went to this is what I can remember. I went to Garden House. It's Garden Compound, the modern little library. We went there, we found some kids there, then we taught them. I really, really, really had fun. I never had this confidence in myself. I like the old me, I can't sit here and tell you what I'm telling you right now. I didn't have any self-esteem in myself. Because like I grew up that life, like someone telling me you can't do anything. So I used to think I can't do anything. Even my mind was just thinking that, oh, if I try this, I can't do anything. So I just used to put myself in the corner. Not like showing up, like showing people the beautiful flower I am. I just used to sit in the corner and not doing anything. But when I started teaching, it made me happy. And I feel happy sharing the knowledge that I have, sharing it to people who are really interested, like in knowing what I have. You know, I know people think as if I'm crazy at times. Yes, because I was working with a tiny computer. Then the Rubik's Cube came up. Yeah, the Rubik's Cube wasn't easy for me to learn. I'm telling you. So yeah, Rubik's Cube, I mean, nakaziva. At first, yeah, I said, okay, yeah, I can do it. But anyway, I kept on learning. I introduced Kuli Joseph. Joseph and Peter, non Peter, akaziva, kuchira nine. I didn't know it. Like Joseph was the first one to teach me how to solve the Rubik's Cube. So, nakana mzangu ameenda kunzisa achiziva achisiriza era ine nikaibochisa sana nikaibochizivisisa kuchisiriza ndipo ameenda kaitla kunzisa nani. The first time I saw the Rubik's Cube, I was happy as if I'm in heaven eating chocolate and ice cream. I felt like I'm flying in the sky. No, like to the moment when I did say, that's the way I was feeling. I was like really, really happy. Then like pen naka panga, since of na mutale so kapwa gushula, and funa kankale chess which I've been no one should disturb it. But spamenazana, oh and kakapangushula no kamba mona putin tipa menza sasa tipa meninza ponzila. So I kept on trying. Now I do competitions with Wim, Olivier.
Yeah, you won me twice.
Yeah, I won. Joseph, like we like doing competition, and like as for me, like when I go with my cube at school, people will call me a weird girl, and some people tell me that I've got gifted hands because I can solve that thing. Like almost like none of the people could solve the Rubik's Cube. Only a few people can solve the Rubik's Cube at school, and people have also told me that he used witchcraft for someone to solve that Rubik's Cube. Then they called me a witch. At times, cause I solve it in a minute and seconds. So one thing I want to tell you guys is like, no matter the condition you are, and like no matter the place where you are, and whatever people are telling you, if someone is distracting you, don't listen to that person. If someone is trying to bring you down, please don't listen to that person. Just go directly to your goal. What you're thinking of. I once told Mr. D that when I didn't know technology, I was just like a little plant growing. But now I feel as if I'm a big, big tree with beautiful leaves and flowers and nice roots, because I'm sharing this knowledge that I have. You see, olomuntakuza iwe paveve unga cheat them life mako, don't listen to them. Iwe nga chio unina shitekelo that you want to do something. Please do it. Mr. D always tells me that if you can do anything you put your mind to. But why do everything? So you have to mind the things you do and the things you